बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेसन आई विल एक्सप्लेन कॉपी वर्क। ग्लोसरी, पैराफ्रेजिंग, स्टेंजा कॉम्प्रिहेंशन एंड क्वेश्चन आंसर्स आर द चैप्टर इंडेक्स। स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर राइटिंग द ग्लोसरी यू विल राइट पैराफ्रेजिंग। स्टेंजा वन, आई विल रीड, यू हैव स्टडीड दीज स्टेंजास इन प्रीवियस लेसन। स्टेंजा वन, व्हाट अ ब्लेसिंग, listen it, what a blessing it is to wake up every single day to hear. Students, open your books and start to read stanza 1. What a blessing it is to wake up every single day to hear the birds chirping as they go on their merry way, and to watch the little squirrels as they come out to play, then to make ready for another crazy and hectic day, or maybe a walk by the stream or stroll along the bay. Thank you lord for letting me live another precious day. The poet says that it is a great blessing to rise up alive every morning. We can listen singing birds and enjoy natural beauty, seeing squirrels at play. We plan daily tiring activities for another day. We spend it by walking casually along the lake or bay. We are thankful to God for granting us another day to live. Second stanza. What a blessing it is to wake up every single day, no matter if it is cold and the sky is dark and gray, and I am snuggled up in bed under my fluffy duvet, or if first light appears over a beautiful clear bay and the sun touches my heart with a piercing little ray. Thank you, Lord, for letting me live another precious day. The poet says that it is a great blessing to rise up alive every morning. It is not a problem if it is cold outside and sky is dark or gloomy. He enjoys sleep lying comfortably in his soft bed. The sunlight starts appearing over the beautiful lake. The sun touches his heart with its tiny rays. We are grateful to God for granting us another day to live. Third stanza. What a blessing it is to wake up every single day to go about with whatever I have planned for the day, then to retire at the end of it happy and gay. Even if my bed be in a barn on a prickly bed of hay, and the horses say good night with a friendly little knee. Thank you, Lord, for letting me live another precious day. The poet says that it is a great blessing to rise up alive every morning. He spends a toiling day and return happily. He feels happy even if he had to sleep in a bed made of hay. He likes to hear the cordial sounds of horses saying good night. Stanza 4. What a blessing it is to wake up every single day. With all these blessings, I have no option but to say life is so wondrous, and admit that really all is okay. And we go down on our knees and with thanks we pray before we drift off into dreamland far, far away. Thank you, Lord, for letting me live another precious day. The poet says that it is a great blessing to rise up alive every morning. He admits that life is wonderful and pleasant. With all these blessings, we must bend on our knees and pray with thanks to God. We must please God before we are taken away to some far lands of dreams. Stanza 1, for stanza comprehension. What a blessing it is to wake up every single day to hear the birds chirping as they go on their merry way, and to watch the little squirrels as they come out to play, then to make ready for another crazy and hectic day, or maybe a walk by the stream or stroll along the bay. Thank you, Lord, for letting me live another precious day. Question number 1. What is the theme of the poem? The theme of the poem is to enjoy the blessings of God. We all must thank for all bright and beautiful things. He has given us plenty of nature beauty. Who are chirping in the morning? The birds are chirping in the morning. They are singing the praises of God in songs. All of us entertain the songs of birds anytime, and to watch the little squirrels as they come out to play. In this line, which figure of speech is used? In this line, the figure of speech is personification. It means to attribute human quality to the animals or non-living things. The squirrels come out to play in the morning. Paraphrase the line. Then to make ready for another crazy and hectic day, the poet says he is getting ready to enjoy the beauty of nature. He is interested in the beauty of nature in a crazy way. He is ready to give bundles of thanks to God. Give the suitable title of the poem. To the poem, the title of this poem is Blessing of God. I can also title the poem as The Beauty of Nature. The poet expresses thank to God. He has gifted him with another day to enjoy the beauty of nature. Question answers. Are we thankful Are we thankful enough to Allah for all our blessings? How? Yes, we are thankful enough to Allah for all the blessings. We don't spoil the nature and enjoy its beauty. We don't harm other creatures anyway. Why is life wondrous? According to the poet, life is wondrous according to the poet because we wake up alive every day. It is amazing that we rise fresh and healthy again after sound sleep. Our Lord gives us another chance to live. Explain the line, before we drift off into dreamland far, far away. The poet wants to say that we must be thankful to Allah for the gift of life. It is obligatory to please Him before we die. We will be driven off to some far land of dreams after death. What is the meaning of the following line? Even if my bed be in a barn on a prickly bed of hay. The poet means that it is a great bless to rise again every day. In response, he doesn't mind if he had to sleep in a farmhouse in a bed of hay. Write down the theme of the poem. What a blessing. The theme of the poem is to be thankful to Allah for rewarding us with uncountable blessings. Its style with the natural settings inspires the readers. How does the poet express his gratitude to God? In the second stanza, the poet expresses his gratitude saying that he will be thankful to Allah even if it is sever cold and the sky becomes dark and gray. He will be humble if the little ray of sun touches his heart. Do this work in your notebook and learn it. Bring your notebook to the school for checking. Stay safe at home. God bless you.